to my tutorial on how to do easy curls that imitate the pin curl style but are much easier using sock curls. Now, people on Instagram and Facebook have been seeing photos of me with socks in my hair and then the next photos of curls, and they've been asking if I could make a video to explain how I do this. The reason I started doing it was because I really like vintage style, but because I'm mostly housebound with energy limiting chronic illness, I was finding it was just too demanding to do a load of pin curls and then a load of brushing out. I just don't have the energy for it. So I was looking for an easier method, and I think sock curls are it.
The absolute basics you need for this tutorial are a hairbrush, some socks. I've got six socks here. A hair clip. Hairspray, a maybe setting lotion, and a hairnet is optional, or a headscarf, which is optional. Now, I have what I think is called a forward graduation at the front, some layers in my hair, and a U-shape at the back. I could do with cutting my hair again, but I previously cut my hair myself to be something like a long middy haircut to help the curls. I've cut my hair myself because I can't tolerate the dye fumes in the hairdressers, or actually normal shampoo. If you'd like to see a tutorial on cutting hair at home, then put a comment below. So I'm starting with slightly damp hair. I actually normally do this when I've washed my hair and it's almost dry. In this particular set, I don't think I made my hair wet enough, so that's worth bearing in mind. So I'm making a parting over the middle of my eyebrow, and I'm sectioning off the top part of my hair. For me, this is quite easy because I've got shorter layers at that point, and then I'm just putting the rest of the hair behind. Putting the top bit again into two sections. Here I'm using a homemade setting lotion. It's slightly better, curls will stay in better if you use a setting lotion. I'm using sugar water. I can add a link to that below, how you can make that at home. Basically, you just need sugar and water. I add a little bit of vodka and essential oils, but that's not essential. Or you can just get a spray bottle and add water. You can also buy ready-made setting lotion. Sometimes I use Jane Carter Wrap and Roll. Okay, so I've tied a knot at the top there, just sort of ordinary knot, and I'm trying to show you that you can do it either so that it's parallel, you're rolling parallel with the parting, rolling under, or you're rolling back, you're rolling under but towards the back of the head, or you're doing it on a diagonal. And now I'm trying to show you the setting pattern that I'm aiming for, which is a bit like what you do for a page boy setting pattern. Here I've got a clip, and this is just an added tip that just for the top one, it's quite useful to clip that in place so that it doesn't move around. You can also use a bigger sock for the top to get a bigger front curl. Okay, so here I am with the setting lotion. As I was saying, I don't think that I've made it quite wet enough in this tutorial. I would say a rule of thumb is, not so you'd think it's wet, but so if you were going to go outside, you'd maybe be a bit worried if you'd be cold going out. Okay, so I'm starting at the bottom of my hair. Sometimes I start part way up to make it easier to tuck the ends in. And then I'm rolling under and I'm tying it in a knot. And a second knot just to make it more secure. If I'm leaving them in overnight, sometimes I undo the second knots so that it's a bit softer to sleep on. For this demonstration, I'm using 6 socks, 2 for the top and 2 on each side. You can also use 4, and I'll show you that a bit later on. Just like with a more traditional pin curl set, you can vary the style, how your hair turns out, by how many socks you use and where you place them. So this is just one example. And also a lot of the style is the technique you use when you're brushing it out at the end. I find with this technique, using socks, particularly if it's only 4 socks, I can sometimes not even need to brush out at all, which is really good for saving energy. Now, when I'm filming this, I really can't see myself, which is something to learn from, and I can't see that a bit of my hair is poking out there, but you definitely want the ends tucked right into the middle so that they're curling. Okay, so I'm obviously doing the same on the other side, sectioning it in half. You can section it either front and back, top and bottom, or a sort of diagonal across section with the sides. And again, rolling it under. All of these are rolled under. It's nothing fancy in that sense. I prefer to use thin natural fibre socks, but that's not important. My significant other has told me to say that this stretches the socks, so you need to use old socks or your own socks for the sake of marital harmony. If you're doing this right at bedtime, I would just do one knot. Okay, so that's my hair tied up. I try to do it so that it's flat at the back, there aren't any tied at the back, so I can light back without it hurting. And I try and tie them all towards the front. And this is obviously me putting on a hairnet. You don't need to do that. And tying on a scarf for good measure. Again, I can't actually see what I'm doing with the setup I've got filming here. Obviously, you'd have both sides tucked in.
Right, I'm back. I've left the socks in overnight to leave plenty of time. You don't need to leave it that long. You can just put them up in the morning, leave them in all day, and then take them out for an evening occasion. Anyway, let's see how they've turned out. I'm afraid that I had some technical issues before, so this is a re-roll of the set I was doing yesterday. It's currently in 4 socks, so we'll see how that turns out.
That setting pattern brushed out loosely with a tiny bit of pomade in it, so a very fluffy style. And this is a different example. I didn't brush it at all, I just used pomade and shaped the curls with my fingers and a bit of teasing. I'm fairly new to modern pin-up and vintage fashion, and the immediate barrier for me was the amount of brushing that a lot of other tutorials show you. I've seen tutorials where they say that you have to brush your hair for half an hour after you've taken them out like this, but I find with socks quite often it's at a level like this where you don't actually really need to do much at this point. You can also change it quite a bit by using combs and clips. So for example, I could just put my hair back up there with a pompadour type of style. Below I'll add links to some tutorials I found useful from Miss Victory Violet, Miss B-Town, Jessica Out of the Closet. I'd be interested to know which aspects of vintage style you find require too much energy. Leave a comment below. So this is the finished look. It's definitely not the best sock curl set I've done, but I hope you like it.